Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to talk about array based interview coding questions. Okay, so we already talked about string based, now we are coming to the array based, and there are like 100 or 150 set of questions. But if you understand at least 50-60 common tricks, if you understand them, then you can solve any kind of problem statement. So till now we covered only stack, queue and linked list, and then we start talking about the array and string. And we are talking about these all different set of questions. So let's talk about this. How do you find the largest and the smallest number of sorted array? So that this we have already covered in the last video. We just assign min max to the array 0 and then we will just iterate and find out which is max and which is min. Okay. Duplicate is same, removing duplicates from string or removing duplicates from array, it is the same question. In JavaScript it can be solved using just a filter method, or you can use simple new set, right? We have already talked about this question in the above. If I try to find this out, okay, so we did this in removing the duplicates from array, right? This is, so this applies for string and array both, right? Same questions. I mean, here we are converting string into array and we already have an array here. We are doing filter and we are removing the duplicates from an array. Okay, simple, straightforward. Now, how do you search for a target value in the rotated array, or how do you sort elements? So for sorting in JavaScript, you can use sort. And you can get min max also by just applying sort. So how it works is you just pass sort, and this is the callback function, and here you can actually define the sorting behavior. It is like ascending order, descending order, and now sorted numbers will be a sorted. Okay, now you can actually, array of 0 will be the min, array of length minus 1 will be the max element of an array. Okay, coming to the other questions, this sequence we try to cover that using sliding window problem. Okay, find the length of longest consecutive sequence. This is the common problem in the string also, where you have given a string or you have given an array, you have to find the length of longest consecutive elements. Okay, how is an integer array sorted in place of using quicksort algorithm? So these sorting algorithm like bubble sort, insertion sort, heap sort, merge sort, all these we'll be talking separately in the sorting and searching algorithm, like how you can apply searching and sorting in an array in the optimal manner. Like you wanted to do a search, then you can do a binary search or linear search. Okay, as simply a binary search, where you are actually splitting the array into half and then comparing whatever the element you are searching that lies in the first half or second half, and then you keep dividing the size of an array to the half. So it's like n log n problem. Okay, implementing a stack queue using linked list or array using, what is the difference between array and linked list, which we have already covered, what are the duplicates, how are the duplicates removed from an array without using library. So you can just use new set, or you can iterate onto the array, you can use simple array dot filter. Okay, how do you search a target value in the rotated array? I mean, and another problem is also like how you can rotate an array in JavaScript. I mean, rotation is same as what we have done in the string. So in the array, we see these more important methods, which is array dot prototype dot shift and shift. So whenever you wanted to put some element, you can do a shift. Okay, shift will remove the element, unshift will actually add an element, or you can say the append an element from the starting. And we also talked about this push and pop. I'm talking about my previous videos where I have covered already all these things, how you can rotate an array to the nth index. Like you wanted to rotate an array in the left 3 times. Okay, consider your array is initially this 1 2 3 4, okay, 5 6. Okay, and what you want after doing 2 rotations, your array will be 5 6 1, 2, 3, 4, right? This is how your, this is what your array will become, right? So what we are doing is, we are doing pop and we are doing unshift. So you will do a pop, you will get 6, array.pop, and you will do unshift of this 6 element. So it will get appended in the beginning of an array. Then again you do pop, you will get 5, and you just append it in the beginning of an array using unshift operator. Okay, this is how we do the array rotation. Okay, so these are like very common set of methods: removing the duplicates, rotating an array, finding out a particular element using linear search, using binary search, okay, how to remove duplicates, trying to find out which particular array index is occurring maximum number of times, finding the min or max, finding the first maximum, second maximum, third maximum. This can also be a problem statement where you will create a 3 variables, max, second max, third max, and based on your comparison you will keep assigning them. Okay, so this is the first set I have. So on my GitHub I already covered all set of questions. So even if you go through them one by one and try to think, okay, how I can solve this question, lot of things will be sorted, right? So most of the things can be solved either in an array or a string by creating a map. Okay, even this finding the duplicates from an array can also be solved using map. So consider you have an array. Okay, this is your array. Okay, in this array, how you can actually write a method, remove duplicates. We have written these methods using different approaches. I mean, I know like we have covered 5 or 6 approaches to remove the duplicates from array or a string. So what we are doing is we are having a map. Okay, and we will iterate onto this array using a for of loop. Let I of this array. Now what we will do is, here we will compare if map of I, map of array of I, map of array of I, I mean you can run a simple loop. What does this mean is, we have a map, okay, and we have this array. Here we are checking that in this map, array of I, what will be array of I here? 1, okay. Does the map contains this value or not? If not, then first time what we will do is, we will assign it first time to consider like true. And this is coming for the first time, so we will have a new array, const output array you say, and what we will do is out.push array of I. Okay, that we are doing only if array, map of array of I is null. That means in map that element doesn't exist. Okay, it will return null and undefined, then it will become true and we are doing push. But consider that 1 is coming again, then map already having the value of object property 1. This is what map is holding, right? It is already having true, right? So in that case map is already having the value 1, so it will go directly to false. That means we don't want to do anything with that. So this out will give us the final array which will have only unique elements inside. Okay, so map of array of I, if element is not there, then we are assigning it to true and then we are doing out.push. That we are doing only if element is not there, right? So there are many ways to solve this. This is one of it. Okay, so what we will do is in the next video we will talk about next set of array related questions.